Hey everybody, and welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem Part 64. Sorry for the short and kind of boring chapter last episode, but hopefully we can make up for that on this episode. Lord Ellwood, Lord Hector! Melanus, thank you for everything. You may have sooner stuff than I had imagined. Thought you'd have fled by now. Double conjunctions.
Sniff, sniff. I thought as much. You're not taking me with you. Sniff. Oh.
That's disgusting. Cry if you must, but do something about that runny nose. What are we supposed to do? You can't fight, so we can't afford to take you with us. Take this, and return to Fargus's ship.
What is this, may I ask?
A letter of introduction. Take this to Ostia, and you'll be able to do good business there. Of course, if we fail in our mission, it's just a worthless slip of paper.
But I must protest. For the rest of my days, I vowed in my heart to continue serving you both. Please, oh please, do not abandon me.
Madness. Then go get on the boat and pray for our safe return. Please, have faith in us. Wait for us.
Sniff, sniff. I understand.
Until the end of time, my lord. I will wait for you until the end of time.
Please, come back. Safely, please.
Yeah, okay, we're going. Bye. We'll be back.
Oh, Lord Ellwood. Oh, my. Oh, dear.
Oh, boy.
Nigel.
Pah, you're here. But you're too late. The gate is already opened. I will claim the mighty quintessence of dragons. I will become stronger and move ever closer to perfection.
How many lives must you steal before you're satisfied?
It's not only those who die. What about the ones I left behind in pain and sorrow? What about them?
I am who I am. The pain of others I do not feel. The sorrow of others does not touch me. Death feeds me, death pleases me, I am the essence I consume. You fools will become corpses here because I wish it to be. Rise and come forth, my servants.
Oh dear. Oh dear. Oh dear.
This... You seem impressed with my work. Or perhaps it's just that you've seen a familiar face.
That's Marquis Laos. And those are Black Fang members. What have you done, Nigel?
These morphs you see before you, I have given them the abilities and appearances of the people whose essence I used to craft them. Well, that's not entirely true. I've made them far more powerful. This is the ideal plan for hypocrites like you, especially you, Ellwood. You continue to regret causing harm to anyone, even enemies. However, no matter the reason, once the deed is done, it's done. Whether you enjoy it or not is irrelevant. The result is the same.
It is not the same. If you feel no horror for taking someone else's life, then you yourself are not alive.
Hehehe. Your weakness runs deep in you. You can never understand. The concepts of good and evil are devoid of any meaning, any value. These ideas prevent humans from liberating their own strengths. Such foolishness, the ultimate foolishness of the human race.
Nigel, after all these years, you have not stopped to reconsider your ideas at all.
And the same is true of you, Athos. You must see the truth of it. All living creatures take energy from somewhere. We all use it to create, to change it into something better. The knowledge of Arcadia has shown us the road to the ultimate transformation. And yet you will not take that road. Why do you reject the obvious?
I'm not opposed to the quest for power, for greater knowledge. However, that quest must be driven from within. To fuel your quest with the stolen lives of others. This brings not wisdom, but abomination.
I remember. I still remember. Those words are unchanged from when you first said them ages back. When you and the dragons conspired to bury me. Look at this wound. The wound I took from your magic. It was a mistake. The only person who understood, the man I thought my truest friend. It was a mistake to try and destroy me. It confirms some things for me. That trust brings betrayal. That friends bring weakness. Is that what you've learned from your encounter? Then you are a fool. Do you believe for a moment that when wise Athos struck down his dearest friend, he felt nothing? His heart was torn in two, and yet you refuse to understand that. Edward. Nergal, I will defeat you here today. But even now, there's no hatred in my heart. You who were born human, you who ask the heart that defines your humanity. For you, I have nothing but pity.
Pity?
Amusing. A weak fool like you has pity for me. Interesting. Now, if you hope to defeat me, you may have your chance. Of course, you will have to best my morphs first. Listen to me. This is my fight now. Mine alone. Everyone, stay back. Hey, what are you talking about? We've come this far together, haven't we? That's right. I've said before, we all feel the same. Hector, Lindis.
Don't forget me, Lord Elwood. And Ninian, I'm sure she's here as well.
Nils. Ah, Joel, you too? Sure, yeah. I'll do whatever I can to help. Blessed St. Elmine, get us strength to win this with ease.
If I die here, so be it.
I'm Dye, brave human of Fargus's pirates, and I fear nothing.
Blessed St. Elmine, please grant us a miracle.
What are you worried about? With me here, we can't lose.
Everyone.
Let's go. We've got to stop Nergal.
Ah, yeah. And so it begins the final chapter.
Oh, dear. Or the final chapter begins again. Yeah, I may or may not have died. But, oh well. That is in the past. I totally forgot to give anyone the, Actually, there are two things I forgot to give them. Hopefully I won't regret not giving them those. We kind of lined out to do this a third time. But nonetheless, it is what it is. What it is. Anyway, so let's begin, shall we? So, yes. Here we have Uhai again. And he has a Reen Fletcher. A level S bow. And he has two snipers with him. Behind each of these six doors down here, there are, well, guys who we fought before. Except they're a lot stronger. So be careful of that fact. Because, yeah, that's painful. Let's just do this. So I forgot to give anyone the iron rune. I also forgot to bring a restore stave. Which may be an issue later. We'll see. No, I can't use that. Can I use... Yes, I can use that. Yeah, let's do that. So, Athos, the Archsage. I should show him off before I just continue on. So yeah, he has four blades, which is a really powerful weapon. And it gives him five extra luck. And that's not the only weapon that does that type of thing. Rulia does as well. Boosts resistance by 5. Which is really nice. Let's see. Who else? Thranduil boosts strength by 5. Sulcati boosts resistance by 5. And Armaz boosts defense by 5. So that's really, really handy.
and shall prove very invaluable. So there we go. Level up, which is always nice. How do we want to go about this? I know that Uhai will be very, very dangerous. I kind of want to play for Athos and let him strike down some bolting at Uhai. Yeah, get some nice damage on him. Bam! Some lightning. Some bolting, perhaps, even. I don't really want to risk Rebecca dying, but this should be good, though. Assuming Lucius doesn't die to whoever is next, but, which is heavier, Rolia? Rolia's lighter. So we kill him with that. You notice they change a less pasty white color once they die. And they all smile happily. So we got Rian Fletcher. And we shall discard. Or I guess, since apparently it's heavier than Rolia, which is not too terribly useful for Rolia. Let's see. This one? No, this one. Yeah, since I've gone through this chapter once before, I have some recognition of the pattern of the door, so I'm trying to use that to my advantage and not die as much as I could. Don't kill Lucius. Not quite yet. He must live! Okay, so what's this dude? I didn't really go over Athos. Good grief. Okay, so Athos, he's got level S and everything. He's an Archsage. An honorific bestowed upon the wisest of sages. And he is an Archsage, one of the 8 legendary heroes. Which is pretty cool. He's got some pretty awesome stats. Actually, be kind of fun to just, like, keep all your stat boosting items and get him maxed out on everything. That'd be kind of fun, actually. The one thing is, he does have really low HP. Let's see. That'd be decent. Let's try this. Let's do Minnie's Grace. And see how that works against him. With him. For him. And we'll go in with a Killing Edge. Yeah, that's pretty good. Awesome. Okay. So, now we'll go and bolting? I was bolting him. This dude has Guest Pinched, which is level S Dark Magic. I'll try and make sure that I don't skip over anything that I already explained last time through, and remember to actually explain this time. So Guest Pinched, level S, Dark Magic, pretty good. So let's drop a Fenrir for that. Animations off for now. Sarah, you can go join them over there, and they're fun. You got Rian Fletcher. You did. So Lucius, go trade that over to Rebecca, and preferably not die. You go kill him. Good job.
I'm proud of you, Vida.
Wow, you actually got a lot of experience there. All the way to level 19. Aw, she's not gonna have max on defense now. Ah, well. These with the these. Let's see where they want everyone. You guys can go over here. All these sword peoples. Should be pretty useful over here. So we'll do that. Okay. Oh man, I forgot to cover him. Kenneth. So Kenneth has Loose, which is level S light magic. Wow, that knee's grace is awesome. Oh, wow. So, yeah, Loose. You can see it there. High critical hit, and actually really high hit rate, too. So, he's got some pretty nice stats.
Over here we have Brendan. Yeah, pretty nasty. He has more than the max HP, and he has low us axe basilicus. Basilicus. Ah, man, I forget that every time. He's level us with both axes, blah, 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 with both axes and bows, which is pretty nasty. A lot of strength. Ton of strength. Let's go in and see what we can do. And the other one is just a random dude person, random warrior. So I should mention before we get too far into this that any of the, well, like Durandal, Sulcati, and Armads, all of those three actually have unique animations, which is pretty cool. And by unique animations, I mean they actually have unique sprites for them, so they don't just look like all the other weapons. It's pretty nice, pretty cool. Just put him there, and you go with four blades and take on Kenneth. That's awesome. And you should be able to finish him. Never mind. Never mind. Lin, you should probably deal with that. Never mind. Okay, so you keep out of range. And, who wants to pick him up? Well, I guess no one can pick him up, so... Well, I guess someone can pick him up. Hector can't. Never mind. You know what, Elwood? You're not doing anything. Go pick up Jafar. And then... I'm gonna see if he was light enough that I could just pick him up with Rebecca. That'd be kind of funny, actually. So let's go ahead and heal up Lucius, since he's kind of hurt. And Vita. Vita carry can backfire. You'll see what I mean by that later. I'll have to throw in that clip later. Brendan. Dangerous. Ow. Awesome. Yeah, make use of Athos. He's really good. He is helpful. I'm dropping bolting. I'm gonna keep the silence stave for now. Okay, so from here we want, how powerful is this? Cause we got Dairin up next. Yeah. The Rex Hosta, he looks really pasty there. Good grief. I mean, pastier than usual. It's pretty impressive. Pretty weird. I don't know why. Let's get these guys up in here. Lucius, go join them. And Vita, what do I want to do with everyone else? Sarah, you can heal up Jafar. One opens up next. Yeah. Up next is the bottom left. But we're going to deal with that. Ow, that hurts. Jeez, that hurt. A lot more than I was hoping. Anyway, he got Basilicus, which is good. I don't have anyone that can rescue him, though, so I'm gonna have to just go for it. Just go for gold. Which I'm imagining may not work too well, but we'll deal with that. Go for it. Yes! Raven! I had faith in you and you did not disappoint me. Yeah. Awesome. Stave, I do not need silence at the moment. Not yet. In time, my child, but not yet. Let's get Jafar over here. Let's get everyone ready for the next door. Anyone who's not being in use over here. Yeah, that should be good. And Hector can take on these two dudes. Yeah. Wow. Nice. Critical hit with arm ads. Oh, it should show the animation. I'll show that shortly. Okay, so up here we have Ursula with Excalibur. Yeah, pretty nasty. Alas, Anima magic. And over here we have Jermaine. He only has a rune sword, but that's basically acts like Nosferatu. So Jermaine, the Death Kite. He's one that we didn't get to fight, unfortunately. But he's basically who you fight in place of Kenneth on that chapter a while back. So I personally find him a lot more fun to fight. He's really fun to fight. But sadly, we didn't get to fight him. But, you know, it is what it is. So that should be safe? Yeah. And here. And you can go here. And you can heal up a raven. Okay, so. Who do I want? I just gotta leave. Darren to Hector, because honestly, Hector can take him on without any issue. And this frees up everyone else for doing stuff. So yeah, Armaz looks pretty awesome. Plus, if you can hear it, just the music that goes with legendary weapons like that is just so awesome. It's so cool. Honestly, the music for this chapter is really cool. It's really awesome. It really makes it feel that much more epic and last chapter-ish. Last chapter-esque. Ow, that hurts. Oh yes, that was awesome. Okay, I'm glad I had animations on for that, because that was boss. That was entirely epic and awesome. We got Rex Hosta, Loveless Lance, which I think I already said. Oh dear, and up next we have Lloyd with the Regal Blade, Loveless Sword, and we have Lloyd and Linus. Listen, Lloyd. Brave Sword and a Tomahawk. Yeah, they're not too terribly pleasant to fight. But I'm going to take a little bit of a roundabout route to deal with them. And you'll probably see why later. But first off, let's deal with these two. So Jafar, go up against Jermaine. Nice. Yeah, as you can see, it heals him every time that he hits. They're doing equal damage to each other, but Jermaine has more health and has healing. However, Jafar does have the ability to get critical hits, whereas Jermaine does not. So I'm gonna go and show Aurelia real quick. Just because it's one of the with magic adult, they all have different animations, which I like. And some of the later magics, really cool animations, plus the music. Oh my gosh. Plus that. Looks awesome. This is why, honestly, it can be really fun just to have a team of magic users on the last chapter. Oh gosh. Increases what? Dodge. I don't need dodge increase. I need to increase the ability to survive things. So, let's see, that'd be 26. Yeah, that should work. I should have shown guest pins, but well. Oh, hey. Nice. Greg lit. I can live with this. Excalibur. We'll discard Spimble better. So Aethys is also nice because you can use all the magics at level S, which is super helpful. So we go ahead and heal up Hector. And who else? Does anyone else need healing? No. Jafar might. Yeah, Jafar could use some. So we go ahead and just heal up Lucius for that. Or heal up Lucius, no. Lucius is going to be doing the healing, but is going to be... I should turn... Just turn Lucius' animations off now. Level up, yes. To get more magic. No more resist. Yeah, Lucius is finally maxed out on magic. He has 33 resistance. So now Lucius is going to be doing a lot of damage. I'm going to turn Hector's animations off too. I'll have to keep up with remembering whose animations I need on at what point. So that should be good for now. I'll probably readjust next turn. Because I'm going to be doing a bit of a roundabout way to deal with these two. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and can attack to there. So, that should be safe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, attack to there. Okay. So this is the line that none of us should cross. Everyone, get behind this line, and then we'll swarm them next turn. Awesome. So that is the plan. Hopefully I didn't miscalculate, or Nils will probably die. I probably have to restart the chapter, but I do not believe I did. But of course they're going for Nils. That's like the worst thing you could have done, dude. I mean, for me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And attack to there. So you need to be there. I would rescue Nils. And run back as far as you can. So Jafar is safe. Everyone else needs to get back behind Jafar. Or at Jafar's level. So, okay. Sorry, I know this is a really roundabout way to deal with this, but I had bad experiences last time. Not with these two. I actually had a really easy time with these two for once, but with what's right after them. And you'll see what I mean shortly. Ah, of course they're still going for the one much forward. It's rude. That is rude. So that does like nothing. Okay. Let's do this. Rune Fletcher, if I remember correctly. This is what I did last time. Rune Fletcher, and then dart with the Sword Slayer. Because that was pretty boss. It's not quite enough. I think he missed like one level up this time. Okay, so Sarah. That's like just enough. Beautiful. Okay, perfect. Unless I had missed, then that would have not been perfect. Okay, Sword Slayer for the win. So, dart. Now, getting some.
It's a little late, dart!
Jeez. Oh, dear. This could be bad. That's good. Okay. So, we'll go in with Areola, Lilia, and. Vita. I hope this is not a bad decision. Okay. I was hoping you get a critical hit, but whatever. It is what it is. Gosh, Lynn. Seriously? Seriously, Lindis? Okay. Go in Jafar for kill, hopefully. Yes! Excellent. Exactly what I need.